What is up, guys? Boulder here, finally bringing you the start of our Thracia 776 playthrough. Now, those of you who have been around know what's about to go down, but for those of you who are new, how are you doing? I'm poledoo. I do primarily Fire Emblem and Pokemon content here on YouTube, with an emphasis on suffering, not by choice, it's just whatever. If there is a will, there is a way for me to suffer in any game I play. It wasn't supposed to rhyme, but here we are. Thracia 776, the fifth Fire Emblem in the series, and this goes in the middle of Fire Emblem 4, Genealogy. It is a, like, side story, guided, if you will, and fits in there. This is a English translation. This part's not English. The Thracia 776 translation is very rough around the edges, and that's to put it kindly. But when we get into the actual story, the dialogue is translated. Menus are kind of moon-rooney, but get through it. But yeah, how I like to structure Fire Emblem, my Fire Emblem LPs, is that every episode, if possible, which this is a game that can do it, every episode will be one entire chapter, regardless of how short or long that is, with exception of if it's a crazy long chapter, like I'm talking like an hour and a half, I'll cut it in half, and we'll have two videos, a part one and part two of that chapter. But all enclosed, so any sort of cliffhangers is the game doing it, not me. As far as dialogue goes, I like giving the characters voices. I feel like it helps so it's not just this voice for every single character going on. It helps differentiate things, and it's a lot of fun. A lot of people really enjoy it. I know it's not everyone's thing. Okay, I don't want this entire thing to loop. I know it's not everyone's thing, so I understand. And then I'm not some super hard-edge elitist when it comes to this game. We play Fire Emblem to have fun here, so things are not going to be optimal. Someone is probably going to be dead by the end of this. And that is okay. That is plenty okay. But if that doesn't sound like a thing for you, if you want the most optimal thing, you don't want any of the extra things that I am throwing in, then I appreciate you hearing me out and hopefully find what you're looking for elsewhere on YouTube. But for everyone else who is down, let's get into this. I have been so excited to play this game. This is the game that is notoriously difficult. for numerous reasons. I have a file here just to test things out, so I've played the first chapter before, but numerous reasons for why this is difficult, and I'm both terrified, like, I'm more excited than I am terrified. I think this is gonna be a really, really good game, but as we get into it, before I forget, the lovely logo you see down there and in the intro that was drawn up was done by my great friend Kynim. Commissioned her. She does great stuff. I commission her all the time for a reason. She does amazing, amazing work. Almost all the art you see around, like in my channel banner, the logo of this, logo of past projects, and just other assets of those projects have all been commissioned by her. So please, all her links are in the description. Please go check her out. She definitely, definitely deserves any and all love that is thrown her way. Good shit to kind of, man. Okay, so getting this started. On the coast of Thracia, Fiana was an independent village run by a swordswoman named Avel. And she led a band of fighters to protect the neighboring villages from bandits. Avel gave Leif and his comrades a warm welcome. Leif gradually grew up among other youths who resided in Fiana. Together with his loyal knight Finn and his daughter Nana, I was like, that's not Finn, and his daughter Nana. Wait, Finn and his daughter Nana? Really? I didn't know. Proceeded to defeat the Thracian forces and take control of northern Thracia. Shaking off pursuits from the Grand Bell Empire, Leif fled the various cities, such as Leonster and Thracia, before finally arriving at Fiana, a small village on the eastern coast of Thracia. Fiana was an independent village run by a swordswoman named Avel. She led a band of fighters to protect the neighboring villages from bandits. I feel this sense of deja vu. I feel like I just read this sentence 2 seconds ago. Avel gave Leif and his comrades a warm welcome. Leif gradually grew up among other youths who resided in Fiana. And now, in the grand year 776. Chapter 1, The Warrior of Fiana. We got here. Have you found the prince?
No, my lord.
We've searched the village, but the prince is nowhere to be found.
You fool! We don't have much time. I know that the prince is here. Round up the villages, our villagers, and make them talk. We need to find him.
Yes, we are already doing that, my lord, but the villagers say that he isn't here. He apparently left with the Fiana militia to go save some village from a pirate attack.
Fiana militia? What is that?
This village was originally the headquarters of a large group of brigands. A little over a decade ago, a traveling mercenary named Avel cleared out the bandits and took over the village. She then established a militia to protect the nearby villages from bandit attacks. Apparently, she's quite skilled with her sword.
She could be a problem.
No worries, my lord. We have already taken Avel's daughter hostage. We've also captured the daughter of Finn, the knight defending the prince. They'll have no choice but to give in to us now.
Well, not bad for you. Good. I shall take the girls back to Leonster with me. You stay here and wait for the rebels. Make sure you capture the prince when he returns.
Yes, my lord. Someone, bring the girls here. Okay. Hello.
What is your name, girl? Stoutness is cute as well. And the other one?
Okay, 100% Nana.
So you're Finn's daughter. I understand your mother is a princess from Nodian.
I didn't know Finn was the canon father of Nana. Interesting.
You see, you haven't lost your dignity living in a place like this. Well, I've gotten some pleasant surprises to take home with me. Wiseman, I will now be returning to...
Is your name Wiseman? Wiseman? Interesting.
They'll be returning to Manster. I trust you can handle the rest.
Yes, my lord.
Just scooping them up and walking away? Okay. Here we are.
What's happening? Something's wrong.
I don't know who you are.
I'll go take a look, Lady Evil. Please wait here.
Dig the music, though. The little, like, peek and then run away.
Lady Evil, the village is filled with Imperial troops. Looks like they attacked while we were gone.
Are you related? What? Damn those bastards.
Lady Evil, let's go. Come down, Othin.
Othin? Okay.
If you run in there without planning, we'll be beaten down. Why are you so calm?
Havon Haven? Oh boy, the good old Fire Emblem pronunciation game.
Village is being attacked.
I think I'm going with Haven?
No, Haven is right. Calm yourself, Othin. Lord Leif, it looks like the Empire has sought us out. Please, make your escape while we distract the Imperial troops. Finn, take care of him.
Evil, Nana is still in the village. I can't just leave her and run.
I'll ensure her safety, don't worry.
No, that's not it. I've chosen not to run anymore.
Finn, what about you? Are you going to allow Lord Leif to get himself in danger?
Lord Leif is already 15 years old. He is old enough to make his own decisions. As his servant, I will respect his judgment and follow his commands.
Well, we did bring him with us to defeat the pirates. Fine, if Finn says so, it's all right with me.
How old is she?
Well, are we done? Let's hurry up and go kick their asses.
Yes, but be careful.
Although they are Imperial troops, the lower-ranking ones are civilians forced into the army. If you can, don't kill them. Take their weapons and let them escape. Understood?
But we can hurt them until they submit to us, right?
Kill us if we don't.
Yes, but don't overdo it, okay? Especially you, Othin.
Come on, don't you trust me, Lady Evil?
Okay, let's go. Show them the Fiana militia's strength.
Okay. So, I mentioned that this translation is wonky, and I know some of you expressed a desire for me to do a translation, or menu translation patch. This patch is really the only story patch available for Thracia. It's done by someone named Shaya. Link to that will be in the description below if you want to play this for yourself on the version I'm playing. But if we take a look real quick, you can see we have a light and iron, but like all these other things, like attack is swa, and just all these other half Japanese, half gibberish things. You can make out most of, you know, what is necessary. I have checked the menu translations, and I will make screenshots of things that I need, if I need to reference quickly, just to say, oh, like, the thing under Leaf is blank, you know, like, I think it's Authority Stars, and then Movement Stars, which is a thing in this game, which I know about, which is an interesting concept. It lets people, Movement Stars is like, adds to a mechanic where you can it's like a reaction, and it's dependent on your movement stars, and each movement star is 5%, I believe. So, like, if that star is a movement star, Leaf has a 5% chance to be able to move again after his action is done, which is pretty cool. His skills, which you can see, it's called double. I believe this is adept. But just some interesting things. Menu is no different. You can see it says config, but when we go in, it's here. This, however, is one of the coolest things to me. There's an RGB sliders for the UI. I love that. Personally, love it to death. I believe this is text, so fastest. I believe I looked at all this in English. And then I believe this is the speed of the game. Okay, but we need to look at our units, so I already had Leaf up, but we'll touch on him last. We can go through growths. I like giving characters
their little spotlight, see what kind of character they are. We're going to start with Haven. He's on Serenus, which is where I'm getting this information, as Halvin. So maybe he's Haven. He's an axe fighter with 80 HP, 40 strength, 5 magic. So magic and strength are separated in this game. 20 skill, 30 speed, 30 luck, 30 defense, 30 build, which I'm not entirely sure what that is. And then something unique to Thracia is movement growth. He has a 2% movement growth, so he could actually level to the point of getting an extra movement, which that to me is really cool. There's a lot of things in this game that are very interesting, like a fatigue system. But then on the other hand, staves can miss in this game. You can miss a heal. So, you give and take, you know? But he also has ambush, which is vantage. So that's cool. Always attacks. It says always attacks first. I don't think that's true. I'm gonna go with the normal vantage, low HP, then Haven will attack first. But that is Haven. Comes with an iron axe, 7 strength, 7 speed. He has a lot of build, which I don't know if that's like a con system, like the GBA games. Not entirely sure. That is him. We'll go with the other axe fighter, Othan, who I'm going to assume, is this like a board and cord situation? Are they going to be like the same character, just slightly different? He also has an iron axe. Growth-wise, 85 HP, 30 strength, 5 magic, 25 skill, 35 speed, 55 luck. Ooh, a lucky boy. 25 defense, 25 build, and 2 movement. So, comparing that to Haven, he has a lot higher luck. But they just kind of, like, go back and forth with some things. He seems like he's better in a lot of the more valuable spots, like speed. His strength is lower, though. But he has the Wrath skill. Now, if this is anything like the Wrath in Genealogy, it is a guaranteed crit at below half HP, which is very, very nice. Excuse me. But base stats, I mean, lower strength, higher speed. So, already, I dig it. I think he has lower defense, though, as well. But, alright, that is Othan. Let's take a look at Avel. I'm really interested in her. Like a main sword master. So, promoted and level 12? Oh, she is 20 speed. Jesus. Okay. So, Avel's growths do kind of reflect that of an already promoted unit. They look fairly low. 30 HP, like, the only real significant thing she has, and that significant is putting it, you know, being generous, it's her 25 luck there. But I guess if you already have 20 speed, what else do you need? You know, I mean, her strength is kind of low. Ooh, at 9. She has also has a fire sword, which is cool. So we got range with her, in with a door key, and adept for her skills. Now, she has movement and an authority star. I don't know which one's authority and which one's not. I'll figure that out. But she looks pretty solid. I can get behind it. Also, this iron... Is this an iron blade, not an iron sword? This is a 12-might weapon. Do iron swords have 12 might in this game? That has to be a blade. It's 15 weight. No, that's a blade, man. Has to be. And it's C rank, that's a blade. Okay, that makes a lot more sense. Alright, that is Abel. Finn. I love Finn, man. I wasn't sure about him in Genealogy for a bit, but then I love him, man. He has something that's giving him plus 10 luck. The Brave? At our Brave Lance, there's a plus 10 down there. That's interesting. But of course, you know, Finn Actually has some pretty good growth. He's a Lance Knight, so I don't think he's promoted yet. So I guess that's why. 60 HP, solid 35 strength. 35 speed. I don't know how important levels will be in this game. Or how promotion is gonna work in this game yet. It's a Super Famicom game, so I'm kinda going to assume that it is one of the promote ASAP games, but I could be wrong. You guys can let me know. But 45 luck, solid. Does he have Miracle? Oh yes, he still has Miracle, which is called Prayer, but it's Miracle, which is a void. It's not like a live on 1 HP Miracle like some of the more recent games. It just increases your evasion the closer you are to death. So there's a interesting formula in there that figures out how much extra evasion you get. You'll avoid. But of course he has the Brave Lance, and then he has an Iron Sword because if we go here, is it because he's not able to, I think off is the option I'm looking for. There's a demounting in this. So similar to Fire Emblem 3, one of my favorite Fire Emblems, you can dismount your units. I don't know if you'll ever be forced to dismount, but I think it's really cool that you have the option to dismount. But of course, our lord of the game, Leif, spelled like the plant in this game, but traditionally with an I instead of an A, Leif has... I've been told Leif is a lot like Roy in that he's not a great lord, stat-wise. He struggles. So we'll see what happens. Maybe I'll be blessed, maybe I'll be cursed. I got an amazing Roy, and people were kind of astounded as to how my Roy ended up so good in my FE6 playthrough. Maybe we'll have the same thing with Leif, or because I'm saying it, maybe the opposite will happen, and he will get, like, no stats every level up. You know, that is my luck. But he's a light brand and an iron sword. He's getting additional luck from something. He has adept, which we kind of already covered. Growth-wise, though, as you see, the 40 speed is pretty solid. 40 luck, I dig it. He at least has 70 HP, so that he should be able to take a hit. Maybe not tank, but hopefully you won't die, especially with the speed, so no doubling. He has 3 base defense and then 25 defense growth. But he does have a 3 movement growth, as others have had 2 and 1. But that is Leif. Those are all of our characters, all of our units. So finally, let's get things going. We're not done quite yet with our units this chapter. I do know that. I also know the weapon triangle is in this game. But there's some really interesting mechanics here that I don't know if I have access to right away. I mean, I probably do, but we'll see. Let's just wait. Wonder if there's an auto-wait option. I don't know. But animations, at least for the time being, we'll go ahead and keep them on. Why? I don't like that the opening battle was with a crit. That feels like a bad omen. It's like, hey, you're gonna be lucky right here because we're gonna shit all over you here in a second. It's already my turn, okay. So Finn, catch. Okay, so how... Manster, are there people who are labeled... who are not labeled Manster? Because Ava was saying, like, capture them, take their weapons or something. You know, you can do that. But I don't know, like... okay. So catch, I need to attack him to catch. You can see the attack window is pretty fucked up. I know the 17 is our damage output. I believe the 13... Well, no, because that would mean he has 0 defense. He has 10 defense. No, it's 6 defense. Okay, so... 87. Okay, we already had a whiff. But I pressed catch, so... See, now I'm holding someone. All my stats are down because I'm holding someone, similar to how that works, you know, rescuing people in the Game Boy games. And it says, okay, I'm holding Manster. Now... I don't know, there's just so many questions I have with that whole capturing system. Goodbye. I don't know if I want to capture everyone. I mean, then all my stats are going to drop, and I physically can't capture everyone. Unless I'm able to hold multiple people. Maybe that's what build is for? I don't know, man. I want to play it safe because there are archers right there. I could, I guess, sized them up, but whatever, they're going to attack Evil. 28 hit. Now, when I was testing out the game, like I mentioned, I have played this map to completion. But as I was testing out the game, I got hit with a 2%. So, let's see. We got new people. Dad, the battle's already started.
This isn't good. Ava's strong, and I don't know whether she can hold her own against Imperial troops.
Sup? Is that the meme? That is the meme. I didn't understand why he was a meme until I looked at his growth. This is Marty. I know by his face, because he's plastered everywhere.
Here we go again.
So, three new units. Let's take the time to look at them. We got Tanya, who is... I can't see... What is your... If your name's Tanya here, what is it otherwise? Tanya... I don't see her on the growth. Is she, like, in a weird spot? Yeah, she is in a weird spot. Whatever. Tanya. Archer. So hopefully she's good. My favorite weapons. My favorite class in Fire Emblem. But 60... Oh, God. 60 HP. 70 speed, girl. Oh, that is promising. That is promising. The 60 luck, 55 skill. Of course, low strength. No skill either, but 10 base speed. She has 2 base defense with a 15 defense growth. So she's not gonna be tanking things like at all. But I like what I see elsewhere. I'm hopeful. I'm hopeful for Tanya. She also has an iron bow and a door key to start things. Okay. Marty. These are his bases. And, growth-wise, you can see... I mean, magic doesn't really matter. That's gonna be low on most people who aren't mages. But 10 skill, 15 speed. He has 50 luck. Good for you. 40 defense, 75 build. Whatever build is gonna do, he has a 15 base build. But based on his growths... And base stats, he looks like he's meant to carry things and nothing else. Like, he could probably compete with Merlinus to be a convoy. But he has a steel axe, no skills, 32 HP, so he'll be a nice sponge, maybe? I don't know, man. This is an interesting choice to do to a character. But whatever. And then we have Dagda. The beard boy that came in. Warrior, so he's promoted. Hammer and a hand axe. Look at the base stats. Probably doesn't have growths. Yeah, I mean, he has 30 luck. Everything else, really, really low. He has a cost, which is... I don't know how to explain it. It's like, it repeats battles. So instead of, like, Adept, where it's, like, bop, bop, whenever, it, you know, it turns something into a brave weapon, essentially, whenever it procs, a cost repeats the battle. Enemy phase included, or enemy counterattack included in that. So it can be dangerous whenever it procs. You can also wield bows. You can see the E rank there. So that's A rank in axes. Cool. Yeah, growths aren't anything to really look at. But base stats, 10 defense, 15 build, whatever that's doing, 9 speed, 14 strength. I like it. I like what I see, Dagda. I like what I see. All right, we can just run up. We can catch people again. I'm gonna catch you with a hammer, maybe? I mean, I feel like a hammer is really heavy, so I probably can't. Why do you look like fucking something Frankenstein would make? Yep. Mm-hmm. Whew. Okay. Oh, I tried to catch him. I'm just killing him now. Single RNG is great. Let's visit this house. Where's that stupid Othin? Is he fooling around somewhere again? Does Othin need to go down there then? Is that what that means? Othin, someone's calling for you. Alright. Let's have Tanya finish the job, I suppose. I mean, 84 hit rate. We just missed an 81, but there we go. Alright, we'll just run in here. Iron sorted up. Probably kill him. I don't know if there's reason to catching people. They said steal weapons. I don't know if I can actually steal their weapon, like, right now. I know vaguely about, like, you can actually do that at some point, or somehow. We'll take a look at Finn here in a second. Good shit, Haven. Oh my god. These soldiers are getting fucked. Okay, so we go here. Item free. Oh, free the person. Trade. With the Manster. Oh, just that easy. So if I want a weapon, I just run up and take it. Ooh. Does that mean there's no armory shops in the game? Or is this just an extra way to take them for free? So I take it, and then I free him. Dad! I dig that. I definitely dig that. So is there anyone we need to, like, okay, javelin short? Short spear, I guess. I want to take your weapon. Now, okay, so now we gotta go shopping. Short bow, short spear. At least that's what I'm assuming these are, short spear. Maybe it's like the slim lance. I don't know. But I dig this. Now, can anyone just freely trade? That's what I wanna know, because you couldn't do that in Genealogy and it really sucked. Yes, it appears anyone can just freely trade. Let's go. So, immediate thoughts of this game. I dig it. That's also the third crit of this map. That's not a good thing. Normally it would be, but not for me. Good things are only followed by worse things. Like, ooh, thank goodness you're back. Please save our village. Here, take this vulnerary. It's alright. It's nothing compared to what Lady Avril has done for us. Vulna. Oh, okay. That one says vulnerary. Got the moon runes out of there. Okay. Wait, talk. Okay. Dacta, you came.
Ah, Evil, I'm glad you're safe, still. What business does the Empire have all the way out here, that kid?
Yes, that boy's actually the heir to the now-demised kingdom of Leinster. I was hiding him from his pursuers. I'm sorry if I kept it from you.
I thought it was something like that. But no matter, I don't mind as long as I can fight against the Empire.
Are they lovers? Is that why she was sorry for keeping something from him? I don't know, let's throw Marty in there. Alright. Hopefully, whoever's up there, I think Haven, doesn't get bodied. I mean, 46 hit rate. Okay. Also, it looks like maybe my stats drop when I catch, because I didn't double him a second ago when I tried to catch him. But I did just double him then.
1 damage. That's cute. I also really dig having like a Jagan type character being a swordmaster. Seems kind of crazy to me, but let's see here.
Well, then you're working hard. You better not be being a nuisance to Lady Avel.
Come on, spare me the lectures, old man.
Yeah, haven't fixed that foul mouth of yours, have you, kid? Well, anyone here, this is what you came for, right?
Yeah, thanks. I don't feel right unless I fight with this axe.
Stupid kid. Never heard of someone forgetting his weapons to a battle.
Hey, I told you I don't need the lectures.
Well, what are you waiting for? Go and help Lady Avel.
Yeah, I'm going.
Like a better hand axe, a crit hand axe, I suppose? Like, memes aside, surrounding the name Boogie, I don't... Is it just a crit hand axe? That's what it looks like to me. Oh, you have a javelin. Okay, thankfully you missed. Should've looked at that. But it turned out okay. Alright, Marty, I'm gonna let you try. You know, go ahead and catch him for me. We'll see how that goes. I mean, he has a 79 hit rate. I mean, his weapon triangle is helping. But I took him. So, you know. Ooh, and then I can take him. I can switch him out and then, like, give me another javelin. Off you go. I really like this. This is a fun system. We'll see, Oh, this is a different house that guy's on. Can I see, like, what it's called? No. Okay. Dagda. Go for a catch. Maybe a hand axe, because it's lighter. Maybe we'll double. Unless maybe you can't double. He still looks like... Battle sprite. Real gross. There's a cost kicking in. Dagda. Dagda, please. We'll visit this house.
Lady Merita and Lady Nana were taken...
Merita is the dark-haired girl. Okay.
Taken away by the Imperial troops. Go and rescue them. Oh, take this magic ring. Remember, just holding it is pointless. You have to use it to take advantage of this power.
Okay. It's called Life Ring. So it's like, spirit dust, or any other magic boosting, or power ring, I guess, but for just magic. That's what I'm going to assume it is. Let's go over here. Okay. Bill. She's not able to catch this guy, because her build is 8, this guy's build is 9. Is that... Am I looking into, like, Leif won't be able to catch him either. But Dagda, with 15 build, was able to catch this 8 build. I think I'm seeing it. Alright, in that case, let's see. Let's come up here. Let's attack with a fire sword. I want to see it. Probably kill him anyway. Yeah, he dead. Kind of wanted to give that to Leif, but like also, fuck it. Visit this house.
Weapons are expensive, so poor folk like us can't hope to afford them. We have no choice but to capture soldiers and grab their weapons.
And that's the house telling me about that. Okay.
See, I took this from an unsuspecting Imperial soldier while he was sleeping. Go ahead, take it. If you don't need it, you could sell it at a shop for a decent sum.
Iron sword. Sweet. Yeah, I love that. Just run up. Mine now. So cool. These hit rates, man. Man. that crit animation? What did that man do? Like, Abel, don't stop. By all means, do not stop. Oh my god. Okay. Let's see. Let's continue trying to catch this guy, because I haven't taken a short... Oh, you have 58. I didn't even see your hit rate. It's understandable. But we did it. Finally. That! So we get to see it. Map one. That is the multiple movement thing. Alright. So, yeah, it's one range. So I guess it's E rank. I'm going to assume this is like a slim lance. It's called short lance. Not a short spear. That's what I immediately thought when I saw short. Okay, and free him. Okay. God, this is so good. I love this. See how long I love the game. We're in that honeymoon, everything is great phase, which, I mean, I can't say is normal. I didn't have that with Genealogy. It took me a bit to enjoy myself with Genealogy, and then that enjoyment, like, fell face first into the depths of hell. Okay, but I guess another way, taking everyone's weapon is another way of making money. Like, I can catch, take the weapon, go sell it. Oh, speaking of, what, is this a shop or something? It is a shop. What do we got here? Just vulnerates for 600? How much, I have zero cash. Okay, is cash carried per person? Or I guess you're saying if you want vulneraries, do what I just said. Take their weapons and then sell them. Let's visit this. Have you seen my big brother, Haven? I hope he's okay. Okay, another hint. There's Marty. He's over here, okay. I guess let's just head toward the boss. I doubt we'll be able to capture bosses. I mean, he has 12 build. So if Dagda runs up, I can catch bosses? I don't know what a long sword to me is an anti-horse sword. If I catch you with a hammer? There's no way. I mean, we're against the weapon triangle, so I don't expect to hit him. If I die, so do the hostages. You can't hit me either. We're capturing bosses too? Bosses are gonna have the fancy shit. I am digging this. But he's dead now! I wanted it, Dagda. Alright, so real quick. Okay, yeah, it wants me to sell the items I got. Okay. Let's go here with Haven.
Oh, big brother, here, I'll give you this. You could use it, right?
An axe?
It's a nice axe, isn't it? I got it from a strange old lady who came from the lake in the mountain, but I can't really use it, so take it.
Oh, brave axe. Already? And it's 60 use? What? Okay. Also a life ring. Is that, okay, they said magic. So no one I have wants that right now. Okay. Cool shit, man. Seize. Nana, Merita, where are you? Answer me.
You appear to have been taken away by Redrick.
Is the armor boy's name. What? Then they're in Manster?
They've been taken as hostages. It's exactly what that Redrick would think of doing.
Damn, Avil, let's go. We have to rescue them.
Lord Leif.
Avil, they were captured in my place. I'm not a child anymore. I don't want to sacrifice anyone anymore for my own safety.
Very well. We'll leave tomorrow morning. It'll be a tough journey. Please make sure you get your rest.
Okay. A little bit longer first chapter than most games. But goddamn am I digging what I see so far. I've heard there is loads of bullshit that goes down in this game. However, as it currently stands, I am all for it. We'll see how that changes in the future. But thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed. Hopefully you are hyped to see more Thracia. I'm really hyped to get this game just going way deep in it. Oh, it's going to be good. This is going to be a good ride. So yeah, hopefully you enjoyed, and I will see you all next time. Bye.
俺と一緒に書き換えたいそう、OK?